Hydraulic fracturing, commonly known as fracking, is a method used to extract oil and natural gas from deep rock formations beneath the Earth's surface. This technique allows access to natural resources that are otherwise difficult to retrieve and increases the efficiency of resource recovery, particularly for natural gas and petroleum. So, how does fracking work? The fracking process begins by identifying a suitable site for drilling. Typically, low permeability rock formations like coal beds, shales, and tight sands are selected, as these locations pose challenges for conventional extraction methods. Initially, a vertical well is drilled several thousand feet into the ground. After setting up the vertical well, horizontal drilling may also be employed to extend the reach within the rock formation, which maximizes oil or gas extraction. Once the well is established, large quantities of fracking fluid are injected at high pressure into the rock formation. This fluid generally consists of water, sand, and various chemical additives. The high-pressure injection creates fractures in the rock, allowing oil and gas to flow more freely to the surface. The sand in the fracking fluid is crucial, as it keeps the fractures open once they're formed. These fractures can extend over a large area, further maximizing the amount of oil and gas that can be extracted from a single well. Once the fracturing process is complete, the injected fluid begins to return to the surface. This occurs because the internal pressure of the rock formation forces the fluid upward, a process known as flowback or produced water. The fluid that surfaces may contain both the originally injected chemicals and naturally occurring materials, such as metals, hydrocarbons, and radionuclides. This liquid is then either stored in on-site tanks, recycled, or disposed of after appropriate treatment. The primary advantage of hydraulic fracturing is that it allows access to oil and natural gas resources that are difficult to extract using conventional methods. Additionally, the systems and methodologies used in fracking, particularly horizontal drilling, have opened up previously untapped natural gas reserves in areas that were not previously considered major gas producers. For example, shale gas has emerged as a significant energy source due to extraction from shale rock formations through fracking. Hydraulic fracturing is also employed in the geothermal industry to enhance the permeability of underground reservoirs. Since geothermal energy relies on the heat stored beneath the Earth's surface, fracking helps create fractures in the rock, increasing the flow of heat from the rocks to the wells. Moreover, fracking can be used to clean up contaminated sites. A technique called soil vapor extraction is sometimes used to remove volatile organic compounds from the soil by introducing fractures in underground rock formations. It's important to recognize that fracking is associated with various environmental concerns. One of the most serious issues is the potential contamination of underground water supplies. The fracking fluid, which is injected at high pressure into rock formations, may leak into groundwater resources, jeopardizing their safety for drinking. Additionally, in some cases, the wastewater generated during fracking is injected back into the ground. This practice has been linked to increased seismic activity, known as induced seismicity. If not managed properly, the flowback fluids can also pose significant risks, as they may contaminate soil and surface water. Although there are systems in place to minimize these risks, spills do occur, raising concerns about the safety and environmental impact of the entire process. Furthermore, drilling sites can also adversely affect air quality in the surrounding region, impacting both nearby communities and wildlife. While fracking provides access to significant amounts of previously untapped natural resources, it also carries serious environmental and health concerns that cannot be overlooked. It is essential for regulatory bodies, researchers, private companies, and the general public to collaborate in developing a balanced approach to fracking, one that allows us to harness its potential while carefully protecting the planet and the lives it supports.